I want to look at the effects or mode toolbar. I'm calling it that because when I put my arrow over the control, it says effects. When I tear off the toolbar, and I'm doing that by grabbing at the bottom, when I release it, it says mode for the title. To show how the controls work on this toolbar, I'm going to add a shape to our slide. And with that shape selected, controls on the toolbar become active. Clicking on rotate, we've seen this many times. We've got a rotation point in the center that we can move around or move the shape around our rotation point. And this allows us to rotate or skew our object. This is the same rotation that we've already seen and are familiar with. Now I'm going to add a polygon to the screen and click on flip. And we'll notice that this flip is different than the flip that we've already seen up in modify, flip vertically and horizontally. When I click on flip, a line shows up in the center of our object. And it's not really clear what to do here until I move my arrow over one of the handles. Now I see a little box aligning in another box. And this is basically telling us if we grab one of these handles and drag it over, we see our shape flip over that line. Now we can grab one of the ends of the line and move it to wherever we would like on the screen. I can make it horizontal or vertical, which we've already seen in the modify flip horizontally and vertically, but we can also give it an angle of our choosing and have it flip to a different angle. If we want to get a perfect 45 degree angle, I'm going to grab one of these ends and hold down shift. Now when I move my endpoint, it moves in 45 degree increments and allows me to flip it in 45 degrees. If I want to move the line itself, I put the arrow on the line and it allows me to move my line to where I like on the screen. Sometimes I think I'm on the point, but I'm really on the line and I move it. I meant to move the endpoint and I'm grabbing the line. So it might be better to grab it on the outside of the circle to move the circle itself. So that's how flip works. This next one, in 3D rotation object. This one is a great control and a lot of fun, but we're going to cover this one when we start talking about 3D objects. So we're going to come back to that one. This next one, set in circle perspective. Let's add another shape. And I'm going to add some text in here. And with this shape now selected, with the text, I'm going to click on set in circle. This is asking me if it can convert the current shape to a curve. And yes, I want to do that. So that's basically doing the same thing as modify, convert to curve. So that's what it did. And this will allow me to shape this object. Now, when I put my arrow over one of the handles, I now have a little arc with a bunch of lines above it, telling me that I'm going to change the shape. I'm clicking down and moving it. And we see that I've got a perfect quarter circle. And I do have snap to grid on. That's why it snaps so perfectly. If I didn't, it might not work out quite that well. And I can do that with our inside or our outside curve. The one thing we want to make a note about is once it's curved, it doesn't just go back. If I move this back, it reshapes it again. So to get the original shape back, we need to do our undo. And if you've already done it, saved it, and cannot undo, well, then you're going to have to recreate that shape. Now, while we have set and circle up, I'm going to add another shape. This time, I'm going to click on set in circle. It asks me to select this to curve. I say yes. Now I'm going to add some text. And we can already tell that that text looks different than the text in the one that we set to curve after the text was inserted. So now if I click to select, click on Set in Circle, I'm going to make this our quarter circle, and we see that the text did not rotate with the object. So we got to keep that in mind. If we want our text to rotate with the object, we need to add it before we convert it to curve. And as we saw in our previous tutorial, when we convert to a meta file, our text doesn't get quite as blurry as it does when we convert to curve. So if I add a shape and I add some text, now what happens if I convert this to a meta file? Remember, the meta file kept the text a little sharper than when we converted to curve. And we can see that our set and circle is unavailable. So if we convert this to a meta file, this functionality does not work.